If you're building an app inside of no-code tools that you want to share with the world or maybe just share internally, you're gonna love this video because we are gonna be covering the brand new features that were released from Softr at the beginning of 2025. They have done a full revamp on their software. It's been a big lift, but there are some amazing new blocks, new enhancements to how the tool works, and we're gonna unpack it all in this video. So if learning more about the new Softr features is of interest to you, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth and this is Gap Consulting. It's my mission to help you unlock the full potential of no-code tools, and one of our favorite no-code tools is Softr. We have published hundreds of applications for our clients and we even use it internally to build our own applications using no-code tech. Now, at this point, Softr is not its own backend, although they did recently announce that they are looking to include their own data source in the near future. But if you are new to these tools in general, the starting place is getting an understanding of what exactly Softr is. So we're going to be unpacking that in this video, but then diving into the features. But before I get to that, I first want to invite you to follow along with me here in this video. Softr has invited us with an exclusive promo code that you will see on your screen right now. If you go ahead and sign up for Softr, you can enter this promo code as I am displaying here on my screen, and you will get one full month off of their free plan. This is over $150 worth of value. It is a very generous code that Softr has given us, so please take advantage of that and also show some love back to the channel. But without further ado, let's hop on into the heart of it. What is Softr first and foremost? It is a tool that allows you to build your own applications without needing to know how to code. And you can share these applications internally with your own team or externally. And right now, as I already mentioned, Softr is not its own backend, nor is it its own automation or workflow center. What it is at present is the front end component. It allows you to build that front end so that people can interact with the data. And you can publish this to either a progressive web app that you can just download right on your phone, or you can just make it available on a website of your choice. People can log in and you can fully customize their experience. What are they allowed to see? What are they allowed to edit? What are they allowed to create? All of those permissions inside of Softr are very robustly available for you so that you can create these different groups of users. Now, this has all been true for a long time. The exciting part about today's video is the new features. So let's dive on into what Softr looks like today. So here I am inside of my own live application, No Code Accelerator. This is actually an app that we built that we use for our own clients. And so we publish this out. I think there are over 700 or 800 users on this app today. And we just had this big rebrand with Softr, which meant we had to build the entire app from scratch. So this is the first thing. This might come as a bit of a shock to you, but this was such a change of the way that the applications worked that you cannot yet convert an old app to a new app. This does require a fresh build, but if you already have an app stood up in Softr, for us anyway, this didn't take more than a day and a half of light building and tweaking in order to get it up and running. So here I am on the Users tab inside of Softr once I'm inside of an application. And the first thing I want to draw your attention to is this new feature that we can toggle on a new send invitation email. So when a new user is created and in our system, we can automatically send that person an email welcoming them, letting them know, hey, welcome, this is how you log in, etc. And we also have templates, the invitation, one-time code, email change confirmation, and reset password. So all the different users who might access your app, so much easier than before. But what I really want to draw our attention to are the pages, the new blocks, and the theme. So let's go ahead and drop into, I guess, any one of these pages here. I'm going to drop into our courses page. And here is where we're displaying our different courses. And for a while now, we've been able to add these containers so you can flip through, kind of like tabbed, and bring out the different information that you would see here. So this is already readily available in Softr, but you'll notice that these are built now with new blocks. So when we add this component to the container, Softr has given us a lot of new blocks. So if we're looking for, let's say, a list, you're going to notice on the right-hand side, when you're choosing a new block to build with, it's going to tell you if this is a new upgraded block. So we've got all these new features. These just look cleaner, they're crisper. And the best part about all of these new blocks is that they tie back seamlessly to the theme. So now if we want to update our app, this used to be a little spotty in the past. Well, now we can go back here and just say, hey, look, if I want to update the look and feel of this, so long as I have new blocks, they're all going to inherit the default characteristics here. So I can set my family heading. I can set my family font for the body, also the weight. And I can choose my colors, the traditional way that my buttons will look. Now, this is cool, but my favorite update on these new features is actually the way that the header or the navigation bars work. So before in Softr, it was actually quite difficult. This is our header, and we've opted to put it on the side. You'll notice right here on the layout, we can go with top, top and side, or strictly the side. And that's what we've opted for here. Now, the issue that we had in the past was that one header did not have conditional visibility inside of its menus. So if you'll look here, we have a bunch of different options inside of our header. We've got these different headers that are popping up, different options here, and we could not previously make them conditionally visible. And this meant that if you had different users of different groups, it was very difficult. You had to basically create multiple headers on each page, and anytime you made a change, you had to update all of the headers in every page of your app. That took a lot of effort. Now we have one central place. You can see right here that we have the name of the navigation bar, and we can choose conditionally each of these elements. And so in this example, I've got courses. You have to be a user or a member of this app at a certain level in a particular group in order to have access to courses. If you haven't bought that, you're not going to see it when you log in. So we have the conditional visibility now inside of the header to say, hey, specific user types will get access to specific elements on the header. If they don't have that access, then that's not going to show up at all. This makes building the navigations for your app way simpler than before. Now, you'll also notice that each element here on the header has its own icon. And I really like this feature because we can actually shrink this down, and now you get just the icons and a lot more real estate on your app. So if, like me, you are a fan of the side navigation bar, check out the different elements. Just adding those different icons to your different header titles makes a big difference because people can get so much more real estate on their screen, as I said. Now, overall, this is a very snappy update. You'll notice that here we have the ability to choose the soft accent, which is what I have here, or we can just go with the accent, which is going to be the actual primary color. This is all linked to the theme of the app. So again, choosing the colors of your app right here. And the last component here on the nav bar, which I love, is the ability to add a button. So it just gives us that much more flexibility. You'll notice that back in the content section of your nav bar, down here you have buttons. You can add multiple buttons, show them conditionally if you want. The sky's the limit. The other cool component is the user menu. So the account settings are built automatically now. And so when you create your new app and you look at the account settings, you're going to have a page. In this case, it's called My Account. And right here, you're going to see by default the email, password, and full name. Now, I've already put in a request with Softr to give me more ability here because I want my users to have even more stuff to navigate on their page. But at present, this is the capacity of it. New changes are coming though, so stay tuned for those. Overall, this new feature update just gives these apps a much more modern and sleek, minimalistic appearance, which I really love. I feel like Softr has done a great job of keeping up and making sure that their platform stays relevant. Let me know in the comments below what you think about the new look. Are you going to be rebuilding your apps, or are you going to be waiting for Softr to allow you to do it just with the push of a button? We went pretty quickly in this video, so if there are questions you have that we did not address, feel free to swing by our website, like and subscribe to the channel if you got value here, but most importantly, keep on building.